Hello viewers, welcome to our cookery show on IndiaInTracks.com. Today we are going to make masala sambar and the ingredients are, we'll be requiring 2 cups of shallots, 2 green chilies, 2 tomatoes, 1 capsicum, 1 carrot, small piece of pumpkin, 1 drumstick. These are the vegetables we'll be using. And the masala for the masala sambar is dhania, Bengal gram, urad dal, pepper, jeera, red chilies, fenugreek. The other things we'll be requiring for the sambar are tamarind, turmeric, dal, curry leaves, some salt, coconut, jaggery and asafoetida. We'll start by frying the masala first. We need to dry roast the masala. I'll be using 1 tablespoon of dhania, 1 teaspoon of Bengal gram, 1 teaspoon of urad dal, 1/4 teaspoon of pepper, 1 teaspoon jeera, 1/4 teaspoon of fenugreek and 4 red chilies. We need to dry roast all this together. I've used 1/2 cup of tuvar dal for sambar. We need to cook it well and mash it before we use it for the sambar. And now you can see that the masala is done. It's changed color. It gives a nice aroma. Change a little color. Now what we have to do is cool this before we grind it into paste. We need to grind this along with the coconut. I'll be using about 1 tablespoon of fresh grated coconut. While the masala is getting cool, we can start off by making the sambar. Put all the vegetables, required vegetables, into a cooker. The other vegetables what we can use for making sambar are brinjal, we can use lady's finger, we can use bottle gourd. These are the few vegetables we can use for sambar. Some salt, 1/4 teaspoon of turmeric, and we need to soak the tamarind water. We'll be using this water, tamarind water, for sambar. Once the vegetables are cooked, we can check the saanas and add more tamarind juice if required. So we'll just add about 2 tablespoons initially. We'll be pouring 1 cup of water. Mix everything well. Close the lid. For about 2 whistles, we'll wait. Now the vegetables are done. Wow, they look very colorful. What I'll do is I'll transfer it into a bigger vessel, bigger bowl. Ground the masala into a fine paste along with coconut. Put the masala paste into the sambar. Now we need to check if the salt, the sourness is sufficient. Pour enough water to get the required consistency. We'll put some coriander leaves while boiling the sambar. We need to boil it for some time after adding the masala paste. We need to put some jaggery. Salt was not enough, so I put a little bit of salt. We have to keep tasting until everything is just right. I've added a little more tamarind because it was not enough. And a little bit of salt again and more jaggery. Say 2 tablespoons of jaggery. So you can see the consistency. The sambar keeps getting thick as you boil for a longer period, so you know, if it's too thick, add some more water. It's really important that you keep checking the taste. Once it comes to boil, you can switch it off. It tastes just right and the consistency also is just right. Now what we'll do is, we'll have to do the tempering. We'll use about 1 tablespoon of oil. We'll add about 1 teaspoon of gram dal, 1 teaspoon of urad, 1/4 teaspoon of mustard and 1/4 teaspoon of jeera. Wait for it to splutter. 1 split red chilli. Once the mustard splutter, we'll put the garlic and 1/2 teaspoon of asafoetida. Asafoetida is very good for digestion. Fry the garlic in the oil for some time. Put some curry leaves. Transfer this into the sambar. Sambar is ready. We'll transfer the sambar into a serving bowl. Now our masala sambar is ready. We can serve the sambar with rice, idli or dosa. And please serve it hot.